Hello and welcome to the END webinar, which is focused on the moisture in oil monitoring in power transformers. Before to start, I want to give you a short introduction of END Electronic. We are an Austrian company established in near Linz in Upper Austria since 1979. We are present worldwide in more than 60 countries with subsidiaries and distributors. We are developer and manufacturer here in Austria of sensing elements for air velocity, CO2, dew point, flow, humidity, moisture in oil, the topic of today, pressure, temperature, and we have a product line called Instruments and System. Here in Austria, we are a designated institute to maintain the national measurement standard for air velocity, CO2, dew point, and humidity. In addition, our accredited calibration laboratory can release accredited calibration certificates for air velocity, CO2, dew point, flow, temperature, pressure, and humidity. I am Maurizio Cenzato, the speaker of today. I am from the product management team, and the target of this webinar is to learn something more about the challenges of moisture in oil monitoring in power transformers and which END sensor are suitable for these applications. We will go through some explanation behind the power transformer technology. We will see how it is possible to measure the moisture in oil and what is happening during the operation of the power transformer and which are our products suitable for this market. We can start with a little bit of history about the transformers. So the transformers are a machine which transform a system of alternating voltage and current into another system of voltage current at different values for the purpose of transmitting electrical energy. The first transformer is dated back more than 120 years ago, and the basic concept are still in use today, with the difference that now this machine has a very high technology behind the construction and behind their technology and their development. The transformer play a key role in the transfer of the electricity from the power plant where it is produced to the final destination, which can be industry, houses, or the end users. Electricity transfer means a lot of money behind this application, so you can imagine how big is interesting to maintain this electricity transfer always efficient and to highest level. How it is made? A power transformer. It's important to understand how are made the transformers to understand what is happening during their operation time. There are on the market three categories of power transformer. The first category is the transformers for the power generation, which are the biggest power transformer called the generator step up, GSU. GSU, which are installed into the power plants and connect the generators of the electricity to the high voltage transmission grid. Then there are the transmission transformers placed in some place in the network distribution grid. And then there are the transformers for the large distributions, which are typically step down transformer which distribute the power received from the high voltage network to the low voltage network. In common, they have that are made with the same concept. This picture is showing how it's made a power transformer. So we have a tank. Inside the tank there are the core and windings. There is inside the insulation fluid, there is a control panel to check the efficiency of the transformer, and then there is also a cooling system and insulation fluid reservoir, and then there are the terminals to connect the electrical network. All the main components are in separable parts, means that the repair is difficult, if not impossible, and the expected lifetime is around 25 years. And there are units running since more than 50 years. This is possible thanks to continuous maintenance program, and the part exposed to wear are the insulator, the insulators, and we will see now what how are made the insulator. The dielectric insulation is a combination of two components, the solid insulation and the insulation fluids. So the solid insulation layers are made by simply craft paper or cardboard, which are wrapping the windings and the core of the transformer. Why this very simple material? Because the paper is offering very outstanding electrical property, excellent insulation in a very low thickness, and are inexpensive material. And in addition, thanks to the porosity of the paper, they can absorb the insulation of fluids. In this way, the electric insulation is increased. And the combination of the solid insulation with the fluid insulation has much better the electric insulation properties than the paper and the fluid separately. But there is one thing to consider, that the paper or cardboard are made by cellulose. It means they contain high residual water content. And the presence of water is very critical for the insulation properties of this material. So a dry treatment is required of the entirely transformed before of the final sealing of the transformer. Typically, transformer are placed inside in oven at temperature more than 100 degrees for 3 or 4 days to dry as best as possible the paper and the cardboard layers. The insulation fluids, the liquid insulation part, it's made typically by three types of fluid: the mineral oil, the historical material, and now on the market there are also esters, natural or synthetic, and the silicone oil. Main characteristic is that they are offering very high dielectric strength, excellent thermal conductivity, and are hydrophobic liquids, means they can hold very small quantity of water. All these fluids has a dual function: the electric insulation and heat dissipation. This table shows a comparison between the traditional mineral oil and the new ester or silicon. Ester or silicon are better with respect to the temperature of flash point, quite double than the mineral oil, are better for the aging and water solubility, but the mineral oil has a low viscosity, means a very higher heat dissipation. On the other side, the ester and silicon are more eco-friendly because are biodegradable liquids in case of leakage. And of course, the environmental protection is a factor that must be considered when installing the transformer. On the other side, the price play a key role in the decision of the insulation fluid, because the mineral oil is less expensive than ester and silicon, in the range of 4-8 times. Consider that a power transformer for the generation step up can contain 80,000 liters of oil or more. For this quantity of oil, we are talking about the price range 200,000 of euros for a mineral oil. If we have to use different liquids, the price is 4-8 times more. So the mineral transformer oil, it's the insulation fluid most used in this application. The mineral oil, it's derived from the petroleum distillation, so it's a material which is present in the planet Earth since millions of years. The first uses is dating back more than 100 years ago, and the properties of the mineral oil is that it has a low viscosity, very good heat transfer, the electric strength which is 10 times better than the air, and a very low water solubility. Just at 20 degrees Celsius, this oil can contain only 50 ppm of water. During the working time of the transformer, something is happen inside. So the electric insulation, fluids and solids, homogenize the electric field and allow the optimal heat dissipation. In this way, the transformers withstand to the stress of the electrical network, because the transformer is not working at a constant working load, but the power vary according the network request. So we have a lot of stress from the electrical point of view. In addition, with the working load changes also the temperature of the transformer. The combination of the temperature and stress of the electrical network leads to change of the characteristic of the dielectric insulation. So we have the aging of the insulations, of the dielectric insulations. And the main causes of the dielectric insulation are the temperature, because the temperature accelerates the chemical reactions. Typical oil temperature is the range 28 degrees Celsius with peaks up to 100 degrees C. And the main contaminants dissolved in oil are gases water. Why gases? Because the mineral oil, it's derived from the petroleum, so contains hydrocarbons, and with the temperature, slowly there is the oil decomposition in light hydrocarbons, gases, and other substances that slowly, with time, interacts over the time with the oil, and then this leads to change of the oil properties. To detect the gases, there is a diagnosis method in use, which is called dissolved gas analysis. The other main source of the aging is the water, and we focus our attention on the water as a contaminant, because the 90% of the water is already inside in the insulation layer, because are made by paper or cardboards, which are made by cellulose. So the 90% of the water as contaminant is already inside in the material. Other sources can be some contamination during the refilling process, or the humidity from the surrounding area. Maybe there is some leakage in the tank, not adequate sealing, so there can be contamination, or can be some residual from the construction. So up to now, we saw something about the transformer technology. Now we discuss how to express, how to quantify the moisture in oil. First of all, there is one parameter to consider, which is the water solubility, also known as the saturation curve. It's a curve which is determined by a specific laboratory oil analysis, and describes how much water the oil can content in the ppm before the saturation point. So it just describes the saturation curve of the oil. So each oil has its own saturation curve. And for each temperature, there is a saturation point. And this curve, the water solubility curves, increase with the oil use because there is some interaction between the water, the oil molecules, and the oil can contains more water. So the mineral oil aged can contains quite two times ppm molecules before of the saturation than the brand new oil. How we can quantify the water? We can quantify in the absolute way, just measuring the absolute water content, typically expressed in ppm part per million, and it's a number which describes the number of the amount of water. And there is, but this is it's a very simple number, and we have no indication how close is the moisture level to the saturation point. For example, if we have 25 ppm at this working temperature, we just know that we have 25 ppm inside in our transformer, and checking with the water solubility curve, so we see that if we cool down these 25 ppm down to 5 degrees Celsius, we have the condensation, but we don't know how far we are with respect to the saturation point. So another parameter is necessary, and it's called the relative parameter, which is giving the indication of the relative moisture measurement. Typically, it's called the water activity. It's the ratio between the absolute water content at the working temperature with respect to the saturation point of this temperature. This water activity is expressed in the range 0, 1. 0, it's a completely dry oil. 1, it's fully saturated oil. And there is it's just a relative parameter and it indicates how close is the saturation at any time. There is another way to express the relative parameter. It's called the relative saturation percent, RS. It's just the same parameter multiplied for 100. Instead to express the water content in the range 0-1, we express in percent between 0 and 100. It's the same parameter like the relative humidity in the air. So we saw how we can quantify the water. We have to consider the water solubility. We can measure the ppm, the absolute water content, and the relative parameter. But what happens during the working of the transformer? That there is some moisture variation. So because the water content is not constant inside in the transformer. So first of all, there is one thing to consider, that during the operation of the transformer, the temperature is not the same because the transformer can work at fully load, means lot of power, lot of energy. The temperature inside the transformer is increasing, and the water molecules migrates from the paper to the oil. So the water molecules are released by the paper layer. So inside in the oil, the absolute water content increase, and this is a very slowly process. The water content is not constant during the operation time because there is this continuous releasing and absorbing back of the water molecules by the cardboard layers because of the temperature variation. So when the temperature is cooling down, the water molecules are absorbed back by the paper, and we have the ppm which is decreasing. But when the temperature, the equilibrium temperature is reached, so it means the transformer is working in the stable condition of power, means stable temperature, we can see that there is also another effect to consider, that there is not uniform water distribution inside in the transformer, because on the top part of the transformer, the temperature is higher, And on the bottom part, the temperature is lower. We can quantify this difference up to 30 degrees or more, because the thermal profile is not homogeneous. Depends on the windings, on the core geometry, and also on the circulation of the oil in the cooling system. And so if just considering this example, if inside the oil, in these stable conditions, so we have 25 ppm in the oil, on the top part, we have only 0.15 water activity, 15% relative saturation of the oil. On the bottom part, which is at lowest temperature, the water activity is 0.5 relative saturation of 50%. So we have also non-uniform water distribution. The consequence is that there is some aging of the solid insulation layers. There is one parameter which is called the water content in the paper. It's a properties of the water, and it's a number in percent which describes the water mass inside in the paper. Typically, the dried paper contains only the less than 1% of the water. But because of the continuous exchanging of the water with the oil during the operation time, this parameter can change, and there is no way to measure directly this parameter, but can be estimated by measuring the water activity, the relative saturation, and knowing the specific equilibrium chart of the paper. Experience say that if the water content in paper is higher than 6%, risk of paper breakage increase. So if there is some paper breakage, can be there can happen some shortcut between the windings and the core, and we can have some trouble. In addition, there is another things to consider. There is on the insulation fluid side, on the oil side, there are studies which shows that increased water content degrades the electrical strength of the insulation fluid. Typically, it's generally accepted that when the percent relative saturation is higher than 20%, water activity 0.2, the breakdown voltage decreases significantly. So we have a very high risk of electric shock because of the insulation fluids lost its insulation properties. The consequence of the excess of water inside in a transformer is that the electric properties, the insulation properties decrease. So we have risk of breakage of the insulation layers. We can have an explosion, which is very dangerous. So we have safety issues, of course. And in addition, there can be some environmental contamination, also with unexpected downtime of the entirely network. We can have a very significant economic losses. So we learn something about how to express the water content. Now we see how it is possible to measure the water content. So the typical traditional method is the Carl Fischer titration, so which is a laboratory chemical analysis. It's the traditional offline method, means we have to take from the transformer sample of oil, deliver this small bottle with the sample to the laboratory, and the laboratory makes the analysis. But because of the continuous moisture fluctuation, because of the operating of the transformer, it's very difficult to collect a representative sample of the actual oil conditions. So because we don't know if the transformer was increasing the temperature or cooling down, so the ppm is not a representative value. Anyway, for more accurate results, it's always recommended to record the oil temperature at the time of the sampling. The other method to measure the water inside in the oil is to use the capacitive sensors, which are using a plate capacitors like sensing elements, which is a capacitor with two electrodes. The top electrode is porous, and the water molecules can penetrate inside in the electric polymer material, which is sensitive to the water, and the changing of the capacitance of these components is proportional to the water content inside in the polymer material, and we have a direct measurement of the relative saturation of the water activity. In addition, there is always a temperature sensor, so we have a relative parameter and the temperature always available. And this is a real-time moisture in oil monitoring, because the sensor is placed inside in the oil and we have a real-time the oil conditions. And we manufacture our sensing elements in our state-of-the-art clean rooms since the 1979 here in Austria. In addition, the other advantages of using this capacitive sensor is that knowing the specific A and B water solubility parameters, knowing the saturation curve of the oil, the water content in ppm can be calculated out of the relative saturation and the temperature with a mathematic formula. The maximum value the capacitive sensor can calculate for the ppm is at the saturation point. So more than the saturation, the sensing element cannot measure. So the maximum ppm is the saturation curves. The advantages of the capacitive sensor is that the sensor is placed inside directly in the transformer. So we have inline mounting. We can choose the most representative points of most interesting representative points for sampling of the oil. Typically it's on the bottom side or in the oil flow cooling system where the temperature is lower, so we have a real-time oil condition. In addition, it's very easy to perform on-site calibration of the sensor, and observing the moisture in oil trend over time, we can determine the best period for the preventive maintenance. The typical maintenance to remove the water, it's an online process to drying the oil to remove the excess of water. For example, with 8 weeks of online drying, it's possible to remove up to 20 liters of water in a transformer with 30 tons of oil. So now we see which kind of our sensors are suitable for this application. We have a product line which is called the moisture in oil products. We have five products and for different purposes and different applications. So we have the transmitters with the remote transmitter with the remote probe, the E360. With the remote probe, we can work up to 180 degrees Celsius. We have two products for direct inline mounting, the E364, the compact probe up to 100 degrees Celsius with the Modbus digital output, or the E381 for inline mounting with the display and the analog outputs up to 120 degrees Celsius. We have the handheld device, the Oilport 30 set, and we have the very brand new product, the new probe, which is called MOP 301, and we focus our attention on this product. This product is a digital immersion probe. The immersion and digital are the keywords for this product. Immersion because we can install the probe directly inside in the oil. The probe is compact, inside there is electronic, and on the M12 connector side there is the digital interface. This probe works up to 120 degrees Celsius, we have a direct measurement of water activity, relative saturation and temperature. In addition, thanks to the default settings for the mineral oil, we have the PPM calculation available. The interface is the Modbus RTU interface with the Modbus RTU protocol. We have the RS485 interface. We have two probe length, 200 millimeters and 400 millimeters, which allow the installation in a different position with different deep length. Another feature is that this product is totally user configurable. Thanks to the free configuration software, the user can change the oil solubility parameters for the PPM calculation. It means if the user wants to measure the PPM in oil different than the mineral oil, can change the oil solubility parameters and have the PPM calculation in other oils. In addition, the user can manage oil parameters library, build its own custom Modbus map. So with one request to get all the parameters back, and also possible to adjust and perform an offset to this probe. Thanks to the accessories, the ball valve and the sampling cells, the mounting is facilitated because thanks to this ball valve, we can mount and dismount without all flow of interruption the probe. So even if for maintenance or for any other purpose, it's possible to dismount and mount the probe without the shutdown of the entirely transformer and without to have an interruption of the process of the transformer. In addition, in combination with our Sigma 5, our sensor hub, we can connect the digital probe MOP301 to the Sigma 5 via using the Modbus interface. So the advantage is that we have the display for the on-site visualization of the parameters, and the parameters can be transmitted using the output analog interfaces of the Sigma 5 milliamps or voltage. Typical application, interesting application can be just placing two MOP on the transformer in two different places connected to the Sigma 5 via digital Modbus. We can have on the display the visualization of the relative parameter, relative saturation or water activity at two different points in the transformer. And then we can deliver these two values using the analog output to the control panel. Always, of course, it's always recommended to perform a periodical on-site calibration for all the moisture in all the sensor. The user just using the OilPort 30 set, the handheld device, can go on-site and with this handheld device can check the quality of the oil and how good are the measurement of the sensor using this handheld device. So at the end, the last slide, the conclusion of the discussion of today. So the electric insulation play a key factor inside in the transformer. So we have a solid insulation, the insulation fluids, which are exposed to aging because of the working of the transformer. The aging leads to failure. The water is the main responsible of the aging, and the 90% of the water is already inside in the insulation layers. And during the operation, the water content is changing because of the temperature variation, the temperature gradients, and the absorption from the paper of the water molecules. So thanks to the capacitive sensor, we can measure the oil condition, the water presence inside in the oils in real time, and we can facilitate the preventive maintenance for the transformers. So I can say thank you for your attention. Thank you for your time. You can follow us on our blog. There is the page dedicated to this webinar. If you want to see the product video of the new probe MOP301, just scan this QR code and you will be redirected to our YouTube channel. If you have some questions, you can contact us in any time to this email address. And from my side, it's everything for today. I can say thank you for your attention and follow us on our social media channels and stay tuned with us.